Nicky Hale, the world correspondent here in our Gillespie Group storefront studio. How are you this morning?
I'm doing well.
We are going to keep you around. You know, Rick Snyder was talking about how people could find that RV. If they put the GPS coordinates into it to Michigan Stadium, they could probably go right to it, right?
Right. And in some instances, it looks like people crash into it.
What happened?
So we have some lady, a Canadian lady, who followed her GPS into a marsh and sank her car.
Drove right into a marsh?
Yeah, on her way to work.
Because she was so faithfully following the GPS instructions, like the TomTom or whatever. What are those things called? I don't have one. Garmin and all
right.
that.
Right. I'm not quite sure why she wasn't looking at the road or what she was doing. And just from the article saying that she was on her way to work, you would expect her to know where she was going. So.
Wait, talk about distracted driving, huh?
Yeah, so texting and GPSs apparently.
You see, a man never would have done that because a man doesn't ask for directions.
Really?
Isn't that how it works?
But the GPS gives it to you without you asking, so.
Yeah, but if you follow this, see, if you let the technology take the place of your common sense, that's when you get into trouble, isn't it?
Yes, but I'm terrible with directions, so I rely heavily.
You like
heavily.
That thing.
I need it.
But isn't it true that sometimes it takes you on what you would consider to be a pretty circuitous route?
Yeah, it's not going to necessarily be the most effective. And depending on how old your GPS is, it might not know about construction and road closures or changes for that matter, because I know in Lansing we have roads that go one way and then they change and then go the other way. And
it's an astonishing piece of technology to have all those roads mapped out like that, but it doesn't replace common sense.
No, good old map sometimes is what you need.
Drove right into a marsh. We'll be back with more with Nicky Hale, world correspondent, and maybe we'll play the Answer Man and Answer Woman with Gary Austin when we get
fancy.
Back. Stay tuned for that at 35 after the hour.
It started on Journal Square. And somebody heard it there. He put it right on the air. And now you hear it everywhere. Uptown gave it new licks. Downtown added some tricks. No town makes it sound the same as where it came from.
Sometimes the answers have to be conjured up. Let's put it that way.
No, I still don't
from
get it.
Part
we need,
south.
No, it's not. We need a more thorough
it's
explanation.
It's an old expression, you know.
Yeah,
you,
part north being the hat.
Well, it doesn't come always from the brain.
But the hat, you see, is key.
I am wearing the hat. If you're watching on Fox 47, the Answer Man hat, it's a very elaborate, big sort of puffy red and gold crown. Kind of like Johnny Carson used to wear when he was the great Karnak. But it brings me all the wisdom. And really what happened, Nicky, is people said, that MPS, he's got an answer for everything.
Mm-hmm.
And so I said, I'll be the answer man then. But you today will be the answer woman as well. And Gary Austin will try to stump us with questions based on the news. He's the anchor man. And he's never done it. Never, ever once has the answer man or anyone who has helped him been wrong.
I've come close. I've missed it by that much.
But
every time
that's
MPS,
what Maxwell Smart used to say. Missed it by that much.
But every time MPS somehow manages to conjure up, even though it may be, well, what some may describe as an elusive answer, maybe even a vague answer, it's always for MPS close
accurate.
Enough to be right.
Yeah. It is accurate. It's in the field
it's in
of
the
accuracy.
Ballpark, right?
Right.
I was going to say, in the ballpark.
Where did you hear that expression?
That's close enough.
Oh, I don't know. Isn't it baseball season?
Yeah, it is the playoffs. All right. What is your question?
Close enough for hand grenades and horseshoes. Isn't that the old saying? Something like that. Anyway.
Yeah. Horseshoes and hand grenades.
Yeah, something like
close
that.
Close but no cigar.
Yes.
I love that one.
That's a good
that
one, too.
Close. Now, where did that one come from?
I think it would be a carnival game, right? And you'd close. Win a cigar if you maybe knocked over the milk bottles.
Isn't that? I never knew that.
Close but no cigar.
Isn't that? You know, MPS, I'm considerably older than you. I've been around for a long time, and I've always heard that expression probably countless numbers of times since I was a small toddler, I never knew what that meant until now.
I bet you Nicky Hale's heard the expression "the penny dropped."
Yes.
Oh, now, what does
you know what that means?
Where does
Gary?
That come from? No.
She'll tell you.
That means that you finally got it.
Yeah.
It just means that your penny took a little while to get through the slot and into the little area it needed to go to, like the light bulb suddenly came on.
Yes.
So is that sort of, so for me, the penny just dropped, in other words.
Like one of these days when I say to you the answers come from part south, you'll figure it out and you'll say, the penny dropped.
No.
I finally got it.
But until then, the mystery continues.
Yes.
All right. The Presidential Commission looking into the BP oil spill is reporting that the White House did what? Now, some officials in the White House are accused of doing something here in relation to this horrible oil spill. What is it? Guys, what do you think?
It's not guys. It's man and woman, but okay.
You know.
Delaying something?
Well, I think what she means by that is that the White House did something that has people upset, and, you know, BP is involved.
You're right, MPS. Mm. Well, I tell you what, that's why he's never wrong.
Yep.
That okay. one came from Part South.
Here are the allegations. BP officials now, this is the way the story reads. Those in the White House involving this BP oil spill, they hid spilled data from us. It said the White House blocked a report from the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration last spring that showed estimates for worst-case scenarios for the Gulf spill for whatever reason, according to these allegations. All of this information was not released at the time. Some say it should have been released.
Hey, Gary, what weighs more, a pound of feathers or a pound of rocks?
I would say a pound of rocks.
Wrong. They're both a pound. Didn't
we
cover this once before?
We did.
What is your question?
We must preface this by saying MPS has the advantage of the hat. I do not have a hat.
No.
I do not have the hat that MPS has, so he's at a distinct advantage when it comes to answering questions. Okay, number two. The number of those getting food stamps has reached a what in this country?
Record level?
Yes.
Yeah, see, the world correspondent's in banking, so she knows anything about the financial world. She will get it.
I try.
41.8 million.
Yeah.
Getting food stamps today across it. 41 million?
What is your question?
That's a lot of people. I hope you can get that problem fixed. Okay. Apple reportedly is in a deal with Verizon Telecommunications. What's this deal all about?
Guys. Technology, right, Nikki?
It is. You're right, MPS, again. A version of the popular iPhone can be used on the Verizon network. That's what they're working on. According to this report, Apple will start production on a Verizon-compatible iPhone before the end of the year, and it's going to be available early next year.
So far, so good.
Yes, okay. Let's see here. Oh, what very good team, a very good team in our state, is about to open its season, but there's some concern over ticket availability. What's the team, and what's the ticket situation for this big game coming up Friday night?
You're probably not a hockey fan, Nikki, being from the UK. I mean, I don't think the English hockey team has ever won the Olympic gold medal,
I'm aware of.
If there is one. It's the Red Wings at Joe Louis Arena.
Yes, that's right, MPS, right on target again. Tickets are available still for Friday night's season opener against the Ducks.
Mm.
However, there were fewer than 500 of these at last count. So if you want to get to that game, get a ticket, I guess. The long and short of it, you better move fast.
Perfect again. Answer woman and answer man and anchor man, Gary Austin. Thank you very much. The answer man window is now closed. And with world correspondent Nikki Hale this morning in studio here with us. Nice of you to make an appearance like this. I understand you're a star on Facebook now.
I wouldn't say a star, but people do follow the segments on there, yes.
What is your Facebook page?
World Correspondent Nikki Hale.
World Correspondent Nikki Hale. So if you want to be a friend of her on Facebook and you get messages and all that sort of thing.
Yes. Usually they just put, you know, you rock. And I'm like,
you rock's pretty good.
Clearly not listening.
I think you rock's pretty good. They're going to have a new Superman movie.
Yes, Superman movie is coming out, and they are in the casting section of that right now. And
who will be Superman?
Well, that's what we don't know, and the reason this is coming up as a little controversy is recently there have been several castings for movie roles that are from famous books where people have had big issues with the main actor that's been cast.
They didn't go so well.
No, and after
Daniel
the fact,
Craig is the one that comes to mind, the blonde James Bond. What the heck? What's up with that?
What were they thinking, you know? And they actually, I think there was a website out before the film came out that said, you know, I hate Daniel Craig, and there was a million followers or more or so.
Well, Bond is a British star. I mean, he's a hero. It was written by Ian Fleming, who was actually a British secret agent. What do you think of Daniel Craig?
I like him.
You do?
I do. I have nothing against the way that they've started to portray Bond, and I think Daniel Craig fits that if they're trying to go a little bit more, you know, heavier, darker. I mean,
Hugh Jackman would have been a James Bond, wouldn't he? Hugh Jackman?
He could have been a good James Bond, yes, I could see that.
Clive Owen?
No.
He's a little rougher and a little not as dashing.
I don't, not that, I don't know. Something doesn't say James Bond about Clive Owen to me.
Who's the Irish actor that I like? Colin,
Colin Farrell?
Yeah.
He would have been good. If they were looking for that rougher edge, I think he would have been good. It's whether he could have pulled off the posh English accent the whole time.
He's got a very strong Irish accent.
Well,
anyway, speaking of James Bond, look at this ride I have out in front here now. This is a this is from Cheryl Freeborough, and I'm test driving it because my Buick Rendezvous died. That is a 2009 Mustang convertible, and it's silver/gray, and it is a it has 40,000 miles on it. And
I guess
you know
it's got
what?
Some get-go as well.
Oh man. I drove to work with the top down this morning at 4 in the morning, or 4:30 in the morning, 5 in the morning. I'm looking at the stars on top. It was great, and it really gets going. It's a pony kind of car, right?
Mm-hmm.
$15,000 she's selling that for.
That's a pretty good deal, I think.
I had people, I started driving it yesterday. People walk up to me in the street. Is that yours? I said, no, I'm just testing it. You can have it if you want it. Just call Cheryl Freeborough at Hyundai of Lansing is where she's selling that.
Right.
$15,000 for a Mustang convertible?
That's pretty good, you know, and we're in the market for second cars, you know, Troy and I.
Well.
Apparently I have to go car shopping this weekend. So
James Bond would look good in that, wouldn't he?
You know, I think he would.
Anyone would look good in that.
I think any convertible suits James Bond.
It's really fun. 15 grand. You know, I'm tempted to just buy it myself because I'm testing it and I like it a lot. But
would it be really cold in the winter, though? You'd have to put the top up, right?
Well, I've had convertibles before and I've driven them in the winter and you don't put the top down. But you know what? In the months that you do put the top down, it's glorious.
Yes.
It's a lot of fun.
Yes. I think it suits guys better because we have the issue with the hair in the face.
Yeah, because the funny thing is in a convertible, your hair doesn't blow back like in a Snoopy cartoon.
It swirls.
It swirls and blows forward.
Yeah.
I don't know how the wind, you know, how the aerodynamics work, but anyway. Even
Definitely an issue.
Daniel Craig would look good in that car. 15 grand for that Mustang convertible. And remember, Michael Keaton was a terrible Batman, too. Remember that?
Yes, that was definitely a bad choice.
Be careful when you aspire to be a superhero, says Nicky Hale. Thank you very much for being here with us this morning.